a friend of mine had a similar problem. I just called the assessing officer and I said, look, this has happened. CPC has already adjusted in 11-12. Some demand you have uploaded in 9-10. Now he's due for a refund and all. He has immediately done the rectification and given the. So I hope. We are not shirking our responsibility, but we feel that we are addressing the so many forums. We are also meeting our own officers at the top level and bringing it to their notice.
Appreciate your efforts, yes. But it is just the carrying of communications from the CPC call center. They don't realize.
My problem, ma'am, I will invite you to come and visit CPC and see how it operates. The only thing is that when I'm addressing you before, I mean, just in the tea break, I was expressing to your members how handicapped we feel when we are sitting addressing you here and we are talking in terms of generalities. When you come and see in CPC, any issue that you raise, I'll be able to show you the data there itself on the screen. It will not take. I don't have to look for files and all. On a Pusavius, you can visit as a team.
Yeah, as a team, yes.
Do some
business. As a team, definitely.
And I'll be able to redress your grievance in a befitting manner there. If I put a representative outside, one man, what will you do? He'll take your call and say, okay, I'll look into it. I'll do the these things. He will not coordinate. So the problem is CPC system doesn't extend beyond this thing. There is no facility for others to view the system data. That is the only limitations. A call center, if I have to set up elsewhere, or a sort of a extension of CPC, I have to also provide the entire data, accessibility to entire CPC data, which is presently not possible. So that's why we are so much relying on the existing arrangement of the call center and the facilities that have been made. We are more concerned than you about the grievances caused to the taxpayers. Please take it from me that I am not making a false statement just to for the sake of this thing before a gathering like this. No, appointment, this year, the response we have got from the bodies like ICAI is quite overwhelming. In fact, Mr. Ravi Shankar, when he interacted with them, they said there are 23 odd chapters or something, and each one of them wanted that you CPC team should come and visit us. So it was a real difficult proposition because we are a very small, limited team at CPC, and we cannot go and cover all these centers. So we have taken the call to visit some of the important centers like Delhi, Chennai, Bombay, and Calcutta, and so on. But we have a plan that if the regional smaller councils, some smaller chapters, they can form a team of 2-3 members each, and send a team of 15-20 to CPC on an appointed date. We'll be able to discuss the issues with them, and we can show them the real challenges and the problems there on the spot and do the things. So I think Ravi is coordinating. Ravi Shankar.
So through the chapter, honestly, I've been entirely interacting through the chapter. If there's a team, see, we honestly can't handle 1, 2, 3. If we have a team of, say, 15 to 20 folks who wants to visit CPC from the ICAI, more than welcome. I think all of them have my contacts.
Acknowledgement numbers? Yeah, it is given. Once you after the call is over, they give you the number, a ticket number that is given to you.
We'll give the data specifically for you. No, those details can be worked out.
But we can come with the details.
Yeah, and only acknowledgement numbers, all calls are recorded also. For 3 months, we keep the recorded things to monitor the calls.
Sir, that is pending for some.
Sir, 2 months ago, I got a letter from CPC with regard to my wife's assessment of 2001, 2004, and 2006, and 2007. And saying that this 4 years, there is a demand for 449, 500, 17,000 and 4,000 like this. And I approached the commissioner here, saying that we have already paid the amount. They say we have records only for the 6 years. For the years of 2001 and 2004, we don't have any records at our office.
you give a reply and we'll take the reply, like that I say. I want to know how many years of records will be kept at the income tax office. Because they say they are
demand records.
CPC for 2001. Because we have got the record, we could no, send the record, reply.
See, even though the basic record may not be preserved, like the your income tax, there has been a record maintenance, record policy also which the department follows. Minimum 6 years they have to preserve the record, and in case of appellate proceedings or some court proceedings pending, these records have to be preserved for more number of years and all these things. But the demand related records, like the department has typically got a demand and collection register, which is a record which gets carried forward. Every year they carry forward the demands from the old register and put it into a new register. Demands cleared off are dropped and so on and so forth. So that's a record of the which that record is preserved for all the times. So when the assessing officer has uploaded these demands, he has gone basically on the basis of his register, not the record and all these things.
But he says, we don't have anything. You just give a reply, we'll just take it in the tapal. Like that, I just gave a letter and then it was returned. Because unless we just don't have the records of 2000, how we can reply to the letter of yours?
No, we have not asked any reply for that letter. Please, sir, I request you, sir, to kindly go through that letter.
Yes.
First of all, it is not a notice of demand.
No, it is
simply a communication that these are the demands uploaded by the assessing officer.
Yes.
And if you disagree with those things or some of them have already been cleared, please take it up with the assessing officer. That is plain and simple. That's all that letter. It should not be construed as a demand notice.
Yeah,
at any
time. Yeah, not
that.
See,
plenty of people in this year. Yes, sir. Not the only person. Many people, the last 1 year, more than 200 notices we have received.
It's not a notice.
That is the problem.
I mean, but you can clarify to the assessees that a demand notice is only under section 156 and not under any other provision.
They are
worried about it, that part I accept. But there is no obligation to reply to that letter, that is number one. And it has been made very clear in that letter itself. Second is that it is not a demand notice, because a demand notice can be only under section 156. So you are the persons who have to explain to the taxpayer that thing. We will be very thankful if you do not reply to that letter.
Sir, what?
Instead, you devote that time to get it sorted out with the assessing officers.
So, sir, assessing officer doesn't have record for past years, as rightly pointed out by many people. And this demand notice, if you don't reply, whether it is only intimation and now no action to take, thanks, no there is.
No. I don't think we are in that helpless situation, because there are other provisions like 119 and all in the Income Tax Act, whereby a superior authority can always take a view in order to mitigate a hardship in a specific case. Let us avail of those provisions and.
Sir, with due respect to you, so many things we are taking unless it is confirmed. But just because the assessing officer says 2001 to some 400 due, why do you take action in issuing even intimation to them?
Yes.
I think that is
the
reason. I think when you are taking so much action for confirmation and issuing refund.
Can I fix a limit like that? Like if it is 400, I will not send. If it is 4 lakhs, I will send. rightly or wrongly, we cannot make a value judgment on the quantity of the demand and all these things. We there are, just like you have got a case of 400 and there is all possibility of it as having been paid off, there are also demands which are 4 lakhs and 4 crores made and not paid.
And you will take it more seriously. Now some of the clients say, sir, it is 400 rupees, please pay. I said, why should you pay? You should not pay unless it is due.
Sir.
Four crores you will not give. You will say something.
No, arguments like this can go on forever, but then if you are trying to find a, please, no, this suggestion has been made. This suggestion has already been made, like whether all the demands should be taken into account. There were some suggestions that why some demands which are less than 100 rupees and all. So, if that is the issue, that it can be considered by the appropriate authority and they can take a call. There are some demands which are less than 5,000, whether we will be enforcing, because there are instructions that while issuing refunds, if we will not pay up to a refund of 5,000, we will not be checking up whether there are any arrears or something, demands or so. Some sort of a decision which is practical and can be applied at both ends can be considered. But as a thumb rule, we cannot say that if there is a demand, we will not take into account until the earlier assessment years or something. And please put yourself in our position and then try to look into that.
Sir,
the previous demand has been uploaded. Why the previous
demands
were not uploaded?
Sir, hereafter now time is running out. Now it is 8:05. So we have got lot of questions. Specifically to answer these questions itself, it will take more than 35-40 minutes. Kindly, you please, one by one questions, let us, what is already there on the hand, without answering it is not nice. So questions already there, please let them answer. If time permits, after 8:30 we will think of. Please.
Yeah, this question regarding assessment of 2009-10, gentleman has said, original return was filed after the due date noticing an error, a revised return was filed under 143.1. CPC has passed the order on the original return under 143.1. But the revised return was transferred to AO, and petition under 154 on the original return is pending as revised return is with AO. So this is a case where, see, the facts are like, if you have filed a return late, original return is late, there is no possibility of filing a revised return. So that revised return is not actionable at all. Now, if CPC has already processed the original return and you have filed a rectification, this rectification should be attended and it will be taken into account. Only in those earlier years when the rules of our transmission of data between different systems were not that perfect, and sometimes when the revised return was transferred to the AO, sometimes there is a software lock which prevents CPC from acting on this 154 at our end. But this is not an issue which cannot be, which is completely, I mean, it can be recovered. Only a specific PAN, if we get these things and a request, we will be trying to do the rectification of the original return of 154. Revised return will not be actioned at all.
It is not valid. CPC is not processing, saying revised return has been sent to the processing officer. We will not act on the rectification.
We'll check up that case if you give the PAN.
You just write and give it in there.
Write and give the thing.
I'll give you my card. You may email me. Okay, sir, I filed a return in September 2011 claiming refund of 16 lakhs. When I see processing status, no records are available. When I call the call center, they say under process. Okay. I received refund for the returns filed in March 2012. What do I have to do? Second part is overwrote. I couldn't understand.
No. What I want to say is, even March 10th has been called and I received refund.
Huh.
What about the September return?
September return, we don't have any return to process, so I'm a little surprised.
No, it might be
trapped under one of the defective categories that we have got.
Which assessment year is this?
2010-11? 10-11 or this thing?
No, both are 10-11 or one is 10-11, one is 11-12?
No, both are 10-11.
Both are 10-11. The second one got processed. The first one would have got trapped under defective.
For the same PAN?
No.
Oh, different clients. No, we don't follow any chronology or something. See, the returns get processed on their own merits. If there is some problem with the return, it will get halted and the other return which is clean will go through.
Then you have to set some
No, immediate returns, we are acting on it.
The CPC, what the, it is under process.
Correct, correct.
It should be,
it's no, under process.
It's under
so,
process.
So, what is there to disbelieve it?
No, the big bucket we have is all those cases, sir, described, data not filled. There are 2 lakh cases like that. It is possible that this pan would have got stuck there. We'll have to take a decision on how to handle each of those buckets. We will intimate. As we take it up for processing, if we need to intimate,
If we treat that as a defective, we'll be sending you an intimation under 139.9.
If we can process it, we'll take it up for processing. Is there any control mechanism to check the membership number of chartered accountants mentioned in the return file when 44AB audit details are given? There may be some cases where the SSC gives our member number without acknowledgement and file the return. No, right now there is no control mechanism, but we are trying to put in place a control mechanism. Yeah, it's coming under the new platform. It's already under discussion with the Direct Taxation Committee in Delhi. This is under discussion, so this will be taken up. Mr. A. Venkatesan, how many ITRVs can be sent in a cover to CPC? He, sir, just gave the answer. No, we'll check. Let's finish it, sir. He took a photograph of that, actually. With regard to adjustment of demand of under section 156 with refunds, a case in AY 910, the ITO has sent a demand of 55,500 and we filed rectification petition and got the refund in 910. Okay, in AY 1011, the refund from CPC received after adjustment, the wrong demand, it has been adjusted. Advise what to do. The gap here is AY 910, the ITO has rectified, right? Mr. Venkatesan, the ITO is rectified, that's paper returns. So basically the issue is, once he is given the rectification order, he needs to update the data in the portal. He is not updated that. If we can ask him to update the data in the portal and then file a rectification with us, we can rectify it. The data needs to come to us. Which one? For that, that is why. Once the data is updated, we can file a rectification, it will get cleared. Yeah, not so much. You'll have to file it. That is what it is. The IT, what is it? In Indian Bank, paid. Okay, IT paid under section 140A in Indian Bank is not credit, taken credit in CPC. Then we file for rectification, nothing has happened. So this, I suspect, will be a... I suspect that this could be one of those cases where the credit in 26 AS has not flown into the CPC systems. So we have taken it up. As and when we get data, we will take it up.
Yeah. No, but this is there in 26 AS? Yes, sir. And there is no mistake in the SIN number and date of payment and all those things in the return? This is a specific case, we need to look into it, why it has been. Because in our system, if it is not there, the credit has not come from NSDL.
No, but data has not come. So the same data which is getting processed, right? So it is as simple as that. I think PAN WS Industries, I will need to take it offline. I don't want to take it on this forum formally. I mean, whoever has given. Yeah. An SSE company made an FD. This is little, I'm trying to read the handwriting. Somebody can read it out, Mr. Anand Kumar.
No, by the time you read, I'll be answering to few more questions. MI share made mandatory, rural bank branches have no MI share code. How to fill this field? Can the account number, bank account in some other bank be taken? Rural bank. The only thing is that if the MI share code is not there, then the ECS cannot happen. ECS cannot happen in that. But check will go. Mandatory, since it has been made mandatory, it is better to have an account in a...
Uploaded.
I do not know whether the regional rural banks themselves have taken up the matter for this. Yes.
I gave it to him. He's got it. He's got it. I don't have it.
Registered with CPC, not filed any return for that. I think we have answered this question. The lady asked this question. We have got a FAQ on this e-filing, which I will leave it with the institute. We'll give it to the subcopy. Kindly circulate it. It will have the answers to these questions. Some of the entries in 26A appear as you, unmatched. Whether CPC take credit of this amount? Yes. We don't look into that field at all, whether it is unmatched or provisional or... this question which you said that already the adjustment of 2009 tax demand has been paid, a demand made by CPC under 143.1 for assessment year 2009-10. While processing refund for assessment year 2010-11, the above demand already paid was adjusted. Because of this adjustment, the assessment year 2009-10 has excess tax amount. Yes, we said that sometimes if there is a delay in the tax payment data flowing from the NSDL to our system, this situation can happen. But for 2009-10, please make a request for rectification. If the credit has already come in for your earlier year's payment, we'll be giving credit and refunding that. Request you can make, because once the amount comes in, the earlier adjustment and your tax payment, it will be there in our FS financial account system. Your account, supposing for that PAN, when we see in our report, we have got a PAN-based thing, it will be reflecting all the payments that are made by you. Based on that, we'll be able to compute the refundable amount ourselves. You don't have to worry about it while filling up the 154 request. All you have to do is make a request only for that.
Online. Do it online, yeah.
So when I find the in the remarks column, you mention that in the literal field. You don't have to do
that. Also,
you have a text box there where you can give your reasons for rectification. You fill in there and upload the rectification, it will be taken care of.
While uploading, you have to upload the file also.
Which one? XML.
It is like refiling. Yes, it is like refiling. It is like refiling. You choose the rectification option and refile the whole thing. It is the same. For us, the process is the same. We are processing it with the new data.
Because you have raised this question, let me also point some one or two important things in this connection. The rectification request screen that you are getting on the e-filing site is not only for the incremental part or the part where you need the change, the entire return has to be repopulated. So what you have to do basically is take up your original return software where you have prepared it, correct the data, compile the XML once again, and upload it through that rectification, online rectification portal. Because the data, when the rectification request comes, we reverse the entire processing that has happened on the original return, discard that data of the original return, internally treat this XML which you have uploaded as on the rectification portal as a fresh return. It replaces the earlier data. So if you have made any kind of a data change here which is unwarranted, like which is a subject matter of a revised return, you had earlier in the original return computed the entire thing on an income of 5 lakhs. Now in the rectification you say that your total income has become 4 lakhs, which is not permitted under the rectification, this thing. So this kind of attempt will be rejected at CPC. Rectification is only for a limited area which doesn't change the composition of your income. If you have to change the composition of your income, you have to file a revised return. So that is how it happens internally. internally there is nothing called a rectification, so please don't equate or identify with the manual process of rectification which you might be accustomed in the field. And it's a complete processing of a new return information. Having said that, please have regard to the same assessment year for which you are making a rectification. Your return XML should be for that assessment year. Don't pick up a return. We have got about 19,000 cases rectification applications which have errored out recently because they have picked up a return form of 12-13, created the XML and they have tried to upload in context of a rectification of 10-11 or 11-12.
Data doesn't flow, so we are trying to solve that. Actually.
What is the status of this rectification? May 2011, there were rectifications
with
no response
or
no
activity. Rejection mail has come? Might have gone.
Sir, we don't have anything so old.
In particular case, as per 143.1, the issue refund which is not received, the best
sir, can
find 4 lakhs in due, still nothing.
I'll need the PAN, sir. I need the PAN.
Sir, I will find some.
Sir, I'll need the PAN. This is quite unique. I mean, no, I unless you see the PAN.
No, many. I in fact wanted to show the various reasons for which the rectifications get rejected.
No, sir. This is specific. He's saying so. We'll need to see the PAN. Sir, there is one or two there.
TDS credit in 26AS is final. Why is that? The income tax officers demanding for original TDS certificate. I think we have answered this question earlier. I mean, it is final to certain extent, but we have got instances of the NSDL also revising its earlier data. So such eventualities also exist. So Form 16 is another piece of evidence to corroborate your claim. That is the reason why it is.
E-file total income below taxable limit, claim refund claimed, CPC status NDNR, no demand, no refund. What is the solution? I don't know what is filled because total income below tax, was it filled? I mean, whoever wrote this?
Yeah, yes, sir, it was filled.
Sir, can you file for rectification? Can you try? Just try that. I think it should work. One SSE received refund through bank for that assessment year, but the AO sent another letter asking the SSE to pay the demand. Under such situation, what will prevail, sir? This is quite strange.
Right?
One SSE received refund through the bank for a particular assessment year, but the AO sent a demand letter for the same assessment year. I don't know what under what section.
Assessment year may be wrong.
Nor under what section? I don't know. Both won't have process, it's not possible.
As a process, it shouldn't happen.
143.1, it can't happen.
It cannot happen, but we do not know because the full facts are not here, whether it's a 143.3 demand.
Who sent the question, please?
You can skip it.
I will skip it, sir. No one is there.
143.3 demand might have been raised by the assessing officer after completing scrutiny assessment. Demand notice will come. Same assessment year. See, processing is the first step. Then it may be taken up for scrutiny and a demand might be created.
No, what sir? NSDL credit for
2003.
Yes, that's also. There are several possibilities. That's why we say by and large it shouldn't be happening, but these are the possible causes through which.
When ITRV is not filed within 120 days, we have to upload the return again. At that time, we are not able to upload the return as revised return and not as original return. Why? Yeah, because you have filed an original return and depends on the
date. No. Ravi, I'll this thing, the uploading, when we are trying to upload, the e-filing doesn't make a distinction because you already have a previous return.
There, yeah.
It will treat the second return as a revised return. It doesn't check whether your earlier return was in time or belated or you have sent ITRV or not. But when it comes up for processing,
yeah.
At that time, because there is no earlier return, valid return present, this return is taken as the first and the original return. So, shouldn't be a problem. Yeah. I mean, even if it shows revised, don't get alerted, file that as a, it will be treated as original return.
If revised return is filed, original return filed belated, whether CPC processed them, no, we won't. We can't, the system won't even allow us. How to correct the assessment year in case bankers have put wrong assessment year?
Bank has got a window of 15 days, I think, for correction of the data at bank level. Depending on the nature of mistake, they can do it from a period between 15 days and 3 months. But if it's beyond that time, you can approach the assessing officer. He will correct the challan data. That is in our income tax site, there is a challan correction procedure. And the link is given in the FAQ that I will be living with it.
Yeah, we covered all this. There's one, if ITRV not sent to CPC within 120 days, so return is...
Same question, yeah.
MICR made mandatory, yeah, this covered. How to get password again, somebody has sent. This is a e-filing issue. I think it is validated. At e-filing, you send a mail, they will resend it to you. Validate at e-filing. It's there in the e-filing. They do. No, to my knowledge, they do. So, but there could be a specific instance. And anyway, unfortunately, as CPC, I can't answer it for e-filing. So. Yeah, I think that's all, sir.
Yes, members, we are thankful to you. We have been sending the SMS to you for the past 4-5 days. Are you having a problem with e-filing? Please attend this. So, we are thankful. So many questions have come. Maybe constraints are there, as our election commissioner, Mr. R.K. Mishra, has put it. There are constraints, no doubt. For any problem, we cannot give 100% solution. But to the extent possible, within the given parameters, the CPC is trying its level best. We all must congratulate or say appreciate the efforts put in by the CPC, because they have already come. Please, first appreciate their good work. So that the lapses are there, only system lapses, or say the act is so complicated, so sometimes it needs some breathing time, at least still, as they are saying, a few more months to consolidate all these mistakes and then come back to serve the country and the, especially the assessors through this profession. So we are thankful to both the resource persons, Mr. Ravishankar and Mr. R.K. Mishra, and we are going to acknowledge them. I request Sri R. Srinivasan, Senior CA, to come over here and present a small memento, a book of Palkiwala, to Sri R.K. Mishra. Srinivasan, sir. Thank you. I request Sri CA Suman Kumbat, please to come out to the dais to hand over a small memento to Sri Ravishankar. Now the final job, my colleague in the council and the committee member in this taxation committee, Mr. Gopalakrishna Raju, will propose the vote of thanks. I am thankful to you, in fact, to say, from Vellur, some 5-6 CAs have come. From Nellur, sizable number have come. Around 9 CAs from Nellur have come. From Rajampet, another district, Kadapa. So from far off place also people have come. Just I want to make them know that not only from the city, seeing our SMS and the email, many CAs from different parts have come, taking the trouble, because they want to serve their SSCs. I am thankful to all the CAs also. Now, Gopalakrishna Raju will propose the vote of thanks.
Very thank you, sir, for that opportunity. Both R.K. Mishra, sir, additional CIT, and our own member, Ravishankar, simple in language, smooth in delivery, polite in responding, elite in handling queries, impressive in answering replies, and amazing in giving the statistics. Friends, give them a big round of applause once again. What SSEs think is CPC is monopoly, a complex processing center, and a confusion creation processing center. But sir, thanks for showcasing the magnificent mass handling of documents, the fabulous speed of processing the huge data, and the selfless, untiring service of your the small processing center, vibrant officers and staff. So now we understand that the reality is CPC is a complete processing center and a clarity processing center. Last decade, it was a paper mode and a stamping mode, and the filing used to be done only up to 5 p.m. This decade, it is partly physical mode and partly electronic mode, with or without digital signature, and filing is done 24/7. Future, we believe it will be mobile mode and fully digitized with minimal data entry. Sir, on behalf of each and every one of you here, I have only one question. All said and done, well said and well done. But sir, the pivotal point of raising all these questions is the business rules used by CPC or the tax planning department for back office return processing. The God here is business rules. Can the CPC give the darshan of business rules?
We can give you a view.
No, definitely. If not chartered accountants, nobody else in the world can understand business rules. Your business rule is a derivative of Income Tax Act. Please publish annually business rules. When we understand and comprehend 99.99%, we can understand, yes, this will be the difficulty of the machine processing. So machine is not God, machine is man created. Business rule is man created, and we are there to help and support you every time. Let's change our practice mode. What is happening? Demand notice is periodical, return filing is annual, CPC is eternal, will be there forever, difficulty is also eternal, and the recovery of fees becomes carnal. Maybe our services previously used to be only filing fees. Today it is filing fees, rectification, put together, and they say, sir, where I am going to go? I am there with you for so many years. It is a consolidated package fees. So we should also change our practice mode to charge for each and every electronic transcription. We will also change charging our fees to our clients. Thank you. Thank you, sir, for this beautiful interaction, for making this evening lively. Friends, thank you once again, especially without you, this program is, will never be a success. Today's enrollment has crossed 232. And thanks goes to one and each and every person present here. Jai Hind, friends. We'll meet again the next program. Thank you.